I write poetry, and I translate poetry and prose from Spanish. I work with a lot of emerging poets from Spain and now from different countries in South America, especially Argentina and Chile, and doing a little bit with some poets from Uruguay. And so with that translation work, you're partially a critic, someone almost like a curator, in which you're really working with bringing material to light that people wouldn't otherwise know, or they wouldn't even be able to find. I teach poetry classes, creative writing classes. I'm a practicing poet. I publish work. I edit work. I talk to my students about that. I teach translation courses. I taught a translation seminar last semester, in which the students who were there were practicing as literary translators. So I talk about my work in that class, also bringing in translators as guest speakers so that they can talk about that practice, they can give readings. I don't really distinguish, or I don't separate my service from my research or from my teaching. I work in the letterpress studio where we are right now, and I direct it this year, so that's part of service, but I'm also interested in letterpress printing, and I work with graduate students in here to print broadsides for our reading series, the posters for our lecture series. It was a faculty organization that was trying to raise recognition and oppose rape culture on campus, so we printed up these large posters that say no means no. We did that in the letterpress studio, and I've worked with faculty members from English, Jennifer Sneed in particular, and in the art program, Dirk Fowler, and there are a number of faculty members involved in this, but that's all, you know, part of service. But at the same time, it's part of my teaching and creative practice. Curiosity is what keeps me going, what gets me up in the morning, what keeps me awake during the day. Why do I want to talk to people? I'm curious about what's going on in the world. I'm curious about people's stories. I'm curious about what it is we're all doing in this particular room. The letterpress studio, I'm curious about what kind of print we're going to pull, you know, what beautiful thing we can make. In the class that I just taught, you know, I'm curious about what students are going to identify in a poem, what moves them, what jumps out at them, what bothers them, what confuses them. And I have those same questions and concerns and queries in my own work, or when I approach a new book of poems or a new poet or even an old poet, I'm curious about how that language changes and how language moves me.